So in this class we will study the new chapter that is playing with numbers. Playing with numbers means that we have to calculate in some way or the other that you can make it fun, and we will play with numbers in this chapter. So first we will see about the factors and multiples. So the first thing that we see will be the factors and multiples. So in this class we will study the factors and multiples. So we will start with the help of an example to understand what is factors. Now suppose I have 6 coins with me. I have 6 coins. Okay, I have 6 coins. Now I will arrange these 6 coins in such a way that in any arrangement there will be no changes in the number of coins. Okay, so we will see how. Now the first arrangement, what I will do, I will make these 6 coins in 6 columns. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Okay, so these are the 6 columns. So this is the first arrangement, and the number of coins is not changed. Means 6 coins were there, 6 coins are here also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the first arrangement. Now I will do the second arrangement. Now what I will do, I will make 3 columns, and in each column there will be 2 coins. So you can calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how many columns are there? There are 3 columns, and in each column there are 2 coins. So here also 6 coins. Now in the third arrangement. What I will do, I will make 2 columns, and in each column there will be 3 coins. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So this was the third arrangement. And in fourth arrangement, what will I do? I will make 1 column and put the 6 coins. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is how the arrangement of 6 coins are done in 4 different ways. Now, since we have to understand the factors, what are factors? So we can write this as, can we write, how many columns are there? There are 6 columns. So can I write 6 into 1? Why 6 into 1? Because in each column there is 1 coin. There are 6 columns. I have written 6 columns. And how many coins are there in each column? There are 1 coin in each column. 1. So I will write 6 into 1, which is 6. Now in the second arrangement, you can see how many columns are there. There are 3 columns. So I will write 3. And in each column, how many coins are there? There are 2 coins. So I will write 3 into 2. The answer you will get is 6. Means 6 coins are here also, 6 coins are here also. Now in third arrangement, I have made 2 columns. So can I write 2 into, how many coins are there? 1, 2, 3. So can I write like this? 2 into 3, that is 6. Now in the last arrangement, how many columns are there? There are 1 columns and 6 coins, means 6. So here what can you see, that whatever way we make the arrangement, the answer which you get will be the same. Okay, so in the first arrangement also, second arrangement also, I have made the arrangement in different ways, but the answer which you get will be the same. Now how you will understand, see, 6 into 1 is 6. Now, if I say 6, these are the factors of 6. These are the factors of 6. Here also 6, 3 into 2 is the factor of 6. Factor of 6, 2 into 3 is the factor of 6. 1 into 6 is the factor of 6. Now, if I write 6 and then I write 1, 2, 3 and then 6. So these 4 are the factors of 6. Factors of 6 means the numbers, okay, which are exactly dividing the dividend. If I say exact divisor, they are the exact divisor of the number 6. Means if I divide 6 with 1, 1 6 is 6, I get the remainder 0. Okay. Now if I divide 6 with 2. 2, 3 is 6. I am getting the remainder 0. If I divide 3 with 6, 3 × 3 = 6. I am getting the remainder 0. Now if I divide 6 with 6, 6 × 6. So I got 1 here, I got 2 here, I got 3 here, and here I got 6. So these are the factors of 6. So whenever we have to find the factors, what we have to see that if the number of which we have to find the factors is divisible by the number exactly, means there is no remainder is there, means the remainder is 0, it means these are the factors of 6. Now if I say 4 is the factor of 6 or not, divide 6 with 4. Now 4 × 4, 4 × 2 = 8, 8 is bigger, so we'll take 4, 4 × 4. We are getting the remainder here. So that's why 4 is not the factor of 6. So factors are the numbers, okay, which are the numbers which divide the dividend exactly. Means the divisor, if you divide something, so this is the divisor. This is the divisor, means the number which you, the number from which you are dividing. The number, this is the dividend, and this is the remainder. So here just you have to understand that if you divide a number from a divisor, means if you divide dividend from the divisor and the remainder is 0, it means that number is the factor of the given number. Now if I say find out the factors of 4, okay. So how will you find the factors of 4? You will write 1, because 1 will divide 4 properly. Then I will write 2, because if I divide 4 with 2, 2 × 2, 2 × 4, I am getting the remainder 0. So 2 is also dividing 4. Now 3 will not divide 4. 3 × 3, then I am getting the remainder, so 3 will not divide 4. Now I will divide 4 with 4. 4 × 4. I am getting the 1. Okay, means 4 is also a factor of 4. So this is how we take out the factor. Means if a number is given, okay, suppose 8 is given, and if I say that 8 is divisible by number 2 or number 4 exactly, that means 2 and 4 are the factors of 8. Now if I say divide 8 from 3. So will 3 divide 8 properly? No, there will be remainder remaining. So means 3 is not the factor of 8. Okay, so this is how you take out the factors. Now there are some things which you need to notice that, now suppose I am writing here. Now suppose I am writing here 4, the factors of 4 will be 1, 2 and 4. I am writing here 6, the factors of 6 will be 1, 2, 3 and 6. Then if I write 8, the factors will be 1, 2, 4, then 8. See, 3 I have written. Now what do you observe? Carefully, what are the things which you observe here? You observe here that 1, you are getting in all the numbers, means the factor 1 is present in all the numbers. So we can say 1 is the common factor of every number. Whichever number you take, whether you take 100, whether you take 99, any number you take, 1 is the exactly, 1 is the factor which is present in all the numbers. So we can say 1 is the common factor. Common factor of each of the numbers. So whenever you have to find the factors, then obviously you have to write 1, because 1 is the common factor. 1 will divide the number properly. Now second thing which you notice here is that in 4 table, 4 is there. 6 table, 6 is 6. Here the multiple, 6 is also there. In 8, the factors 8 is also there. It means that the number of which we are finding the factors, they are the factors of their number itself. Okay, means 8 is having the along with the other factors, 8 is also the factor of 8, 6 is also the factor of 6, 4 is also the factor of 4. It means that the number is itself a factor of it. Okay, the number is also a factor of itself. Now one more thing is that when you find out the factors, here you can see 8 is the greatest, here you can see 6 is the greatest, here you can see 4 is the greatest. After that no numbers are there, we will divide 4 or 6 or 8 properly. Okay, so it means that 8 is the greatest factor here present. If I say what is the greatest factor present in 8, you will say 8. If I say what is the greatest factor present in 6, it will be 6. Means the number which is dividing itself, which is having the factors of itself, is also the greatest number and is the greatest number. So this is how we find the factors, and what are the, what we observe, that one is the common factor for all the numbers, and the factor is also, the number is itself a factor of it. Okay, if I have to find a multiple of 9, sorry, factors of 9, then what I will say? I will say that the factors of 9 are 1, 3 and then 9. Means 9 is also a factor of 9. Itself it is a factor. And also that is the greatest factor. So this was all about factors. Now next we will move to multiples. Now we will move to multiples. Multiple means a number. Okay, a number is said to be the multiple of each of its factors. A number is said to be the multiple of each of its factors. Each of its factor. See, what are multiples? A number is said to be the multiple of each of its factor. Now suppose I say 6. What are its factors? 1 into 2 into 3 into 6. Now here these are the factors and 6 is the multiple. Okay, here the number, if you are finding the factors, these are the factors and each of these factors is the multiple of 6. Okay, now in other way you can understand that what are multiples. Now multiples means the table type, the table which you learn. Suppose you are learning, you are saying the table of 6, 6 1 just 6, 6 2 12, 6 3 18. So these are what? These are the multiples. Now if I say find the multiple of 5. If I say find the multiple of 5 and also the factor of 5. So what are the factors of 5? It will be 1 and 5. Nothing more than this. Now if I say find the multiple of, these are the factors. Now I will say find the multiple of 5. So how you will write? You will write 5 1 5, 5 2 10, 5 3 15, 5 4 20 and go on writing. Means it will never end. It is not that 5, 10, 50 and you will end there. No. 5, 11, 50, 5, 5, 12, 60. That will go on till 100, 1000, wherever you want to write, till how much you want to write, you can write. So, multiples are just the tables which you learn. Okay. So, this is how you write. If I say, write the multiples of 5 till 100. Okay. Means before 100, what are the multiples of 5? You can write. Just what are the multiple? You can divide the number, you can just multiply the number, you can write. So these are the multiples. And factors are limited. What are factors means? Factors are those numbers which divide the number exactly. 1 divides the number 5 exactly. 5 divides the number 5 exactly. Now 2 or 3 can't divide the number 5 exactly. Okay. So that's why they are not the factors of 5. But if we find the multiples, we just have to go on moving further. That is like the table you learn, 5 into 1, 5 into 2, 5 into 3. So you go on moving ahead. These are the multiples. Okay. Now if I say write down the multiples of 2, you will write the table of 2. If you have to write the multiples, if I say write down the multiples of 2 till 100. Okay. If I say till 100. Now you will go on writing till 100, unless and until you reach 100, you will not stop. You write down the multiples. Now if I say write the multiples of 2 from 100 till 150. So you will start from 2 into 100 and then to till 100 you will write from 100 and then you will end in 150. Now if I say write down the multiples of, I am saying 2 from 100 to 150. Means what you have to do, you have to divide 2 into 100, that is 200. Then 2 into 101, that is 202. Okay, so this is how you go on writing. Okay, 2 into 100, 2 into 101 till 150. 2 into 150 you will write. Okay, so you will get till here, you will get like this. Okay, you will go on writing. So this is how you write the multiples, this is how you write the factors. The difference between the factors and multiples is that the factors divide the number exactly. Means there are limited number of factors which will divide the number exactly. But multiples, there is, you can find the multiples still how much you want to write, you can go on writing. So this was all about the factors and multiples.